Hi, my name is Bill Raymond from the Bill Talks AI newsletter. I am taking the GenAI course from Kaggle that runs from November 11th through 15, 2024. Bunch of us were taking this and running into some problems on day one. So I'm going to walk you through the common problems that will occur and how to address them. And we're going to start from scratch by going to the welcome email for day one. So you'll notice that it says, complete this code lab. This is the very first thing you need to do. So go to that link. And what it's going to do is open up Kaggle, and it may ask you to create an account. If it does ask you to go create an account, go through all of those steps. But there's one important step you need to check. And even if you think you did this, because I did this yesterday and I thought it was done and it didn't work, you must verify your phone number or you will not be able to use this properly. So after you've set up your account, go to your profile, which is up here on the top right-hand corner, and choose settings. And then make sure that the phone verification says verified. Again, this is Monday for me. I did this on Sunday. I thought I was verified. I don't know what happened. So start here and make sure it says verified. Also, I'm using this email address, which is kind of my consulting company's name. And so that is the email address I'm signed in with. So after all of that is set up, once again, you can go back here to the email if you need to and go to that code lab option. And that will just make sure that you get the day one prompting course. This is going to include text such as descriptions and some additional reading, but it's also going to include code after you scroll down. And the code is going to start with this pip install. Let's not start there yet. The next thing that we need to do is set up an AI Studio account. So what you want to do is go to aistudio.google.com. You'll also have to set up an email address and just make sure everything's set up properly. Now, I don't know if this matters, but it did help me with my debugging that my email address that I used for Kaggle is the same email address I used for AI Studio. I don't know if that's necessary, but you might want to at least try that if you're still struggling and having problems. After you've gone there, you're going to find an Get API Key button. So go ahead and select that. And it will list any API keys that you have set up. Chances are you don't have any. If you've worked with Google Cloud, then you might already have some. I suggest you create an API key just for this session. So go ahead and choose Create API Key. Now for me, it's going to ask what project I want to use, and I'm going to choose Gemini API. Now you might be prompted to create a project. There might be a number of other projects up there. Just select the one that is most relevant to you. I'm going to choose this Gemini one, and then choose Create API Key for that existing project. Now, what's going to happen is it's going to create this key, and I'm going to delete this immediately before I even produce this video, so no one will be able to use it. Do not share this key. This is very special key just for you. No matter what, don't share the key. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this to the clipboard, and you can see it ends in XE4, and then there's that XE4 right down there at the bottom. So again, I'll copy that to my clipboard, and I'll head back to this day one prompting collab notebook. Now, if this is your very first time doing this, what you need to do is kind of take this collab notebook that was provided to you and kind of copy it down, if you will. It's going to create a version just for you. They call this forking or copying. What's going to do is kind of take the one that they gave you and then create one that you can edit and play around with yourself. So choose that copy and edit, or make a copy for myself, or fork it, whatever that link is at the top right-hand corner. I'll choose copy and edit because I already did that. And what will happen is it will load up the same exact file. Now mine is in black and white with the dark color because I have a dark theme turned on. Yours might be white with black text, but that's just because of a preference. Now, again, you'll notice that there's a whole bunch of instructions here before you can even run any code. But one of the things that's in here is it's going to need that API key. And we have not set that up in our notebook yet. So here's what you need to do. I'm just going to scroll back up here to the top. I'll choose add-ons, secrets. And then when I get to the secrets area, you can see I've already set one up. If you haven't done that, it will be blank. So I'm just going to go ahead and delete my secret right now. And this is the screen you're going to see. It's going to say add secret. So I'm just going to go ahead and choose add secret. And I have to do that label exactly the way the code shows, which is Google underscore API underscore key, all in capital letters. Check and recheck that spelling. Make sure it's right. And then for the value, you're going to paste in that API key that you will not share with anyone. Now, what's really important here, this is some of the problems that some people had earlier, was that they had a space or a special character at the very beginning before the start of the key, or a space or a special character at the end. Make sure that this is exactly the way it was in the AI Studio, or it won't work. Now go ahead and save your work. Now, what I'm going to do, just because you might have had issues before, is check the settings option. I'm going to just turn off my internet for a second here. If you see turn on internet, you need to do that. So if you go to settings and it says turn on internet, turn it on, because this is a Kaggle notebook that's going to talk to Gemini in the background, and it needs an internet connection to do that. So even though you might have an internet connection, you have to give that to the Kaggle notebook. So now that it says turn off internet, that's good. We want turn off internet. Now, the other thing we're going to do is, just in case we have run this before, we're just going to choose two different settings under the run menu. We're going to choose start session. And you can see here it says draft session waiting for Jupiter. That could take a little while. If you already had a session started, then that's all good. Don't worry about it. But there's two other things that I want to do just to make sure that everything is good. If you run into any problems before, go back to the run menu and choose restart in clear cell outputs. Next, what I want you to do is go back to the run command once more and choose factory reset. What we're doing here is just making sure that there's no junk, no leftover errors or anything like that getting in our way so that we can run our code. Okay, so now that we have done all of that, if let's say you were running this and some of it was working and some of it wasn't, don't just start down in the middle of the code and start running it. You must, because we did that reset, we must start with the first line of code, which is this pip install. So go ahead and run that. And that's going to take a little bit of time. And so we'll just let that finish and I'll come back when it's done. Cool. That worked. And you'll see this little note here. It says, note, you may need to restart the kernel. Do not worry about that. If you saw some error messages, then at this point, you have a few things to double check. One, make sure that your phone number is verified in your Kaggle settings, your Kaggle settings. Two, make sure that you have the API key set up. Three, make sure that you go to the settings here and make sure the internet is on. Four, go to your secrets. Make sure that your secret says Google API key exactly spelled this way. And then go to your secret and make sure that it does not have any special characters, and you copy and paste that from that this area over here at AI Studio and get that key. Okay, good. So now that we are running, we still haven't done much. What we've done is we've installed some Python stuff that's needed for this Kaggle code. The next thing we're going to do is install some more things, import some things. And so I'm going to go ahead and run that. It'll just take maybe a second, and you won't see any messages underneath it. So the next thing we want to do is find this from Kaggle secrets and run that. Again, you won't see any message, it'll blink of an eye and it'll be done. But if you see any error messages, then that means that your Google API key is not set up properly. Okay, so the next thing that we can do is just run the rest of the code. Now I'm gonna just run a few of these so you can see this code here uses Gemini Flash. That's a specific model that Gemini offers. And you're going to prompt it with code saying, explain AI to me like you're a kid. So I'll just go ahead and press this little run icon here. And you'll see there is a response. So that's kind of it. I hope this is helpful to you. The one thing I will point out, though, is that sometimes when you leave the browser, wait too long, or go to this run menu and maybe restart and clear cell outputs, anytime you do that, and then you just start running code, it may not work. So what you really need to do, anytime you kind of experience some weird stuff where you're just running code in each of these cells and it was working and then it doesn't, then the best thing to do is go to the run menu, restart and clear cell outputs, then come back up here to the pip install, run that, wait for that to finish, run the next one, and then keep going and running each one, because many of them are additive, until you get to the one that you're working on and you should be able to run it. I hope this was helpful to you, and if I run into some other debugging issues or tips and tricks along the way, I'll go ahead and share them tomorrow.